Ayy, popping like I'm supposed to. Watch out for the people that I'm close to. Speak a little something you could toast to. I ain't tryna hear about what you won't do. Moving like I'm into. Hit the ground running like the rent do. Speak a little something that you're into. I ain't tryna hear about what you've been through. Like, hold up, hold up, say what's the hold up.
Yes, I am finally back. So as you can all tell, I took a nice 2 week break off YouTube. It was my final 2 weeks in university, so I went and moved back there, spent the final time with my mates. I thought I'd have a nice healthy break, and as I said it, I'm gonna come back with a bang. So this week, from this Sunday, I'm gonna be posting one video every single day for an entire week. So be sure to hit that subscribe button and put on that notification bell so you won't miss a single video. But yeah, so I am fully finished with university now, so I'm into the real world. I'm an adult technically, so I'm gonna be doing the business full time, and I'm gonna be taking the YouTube full time. I'm gonna be posting two videos every single week after this whole week of content. My aim is to try and hit that 100K within 2 years, so please help me on this journey. But for today's video, you know the drill, it is my June pickups. So in this series, I basically showcase all the items I've purchased or been sent to me throughout the month. This week, we've got a load of good stuff. I can't even lie, like, I've purchased some nice things and then I've been sent some really nice things. So let's jump into it. So now to move on to the first pickup. Usually I should save the best to last, but this thing, honestly, you just need to see this straight away. It is the detailing, like, honestly. So first of all, you can see it's from a brand called Problems. Look at the box. The Sean Wotherspoon colorway, Problems text, and then they've even had the full details around, like, kind of like a shoebox. And they've also put the description right here, exactly like a shoebox. This is the Problems 197 shoulder bag. And as you open this up, this is just perfect for summer, because like, Sean Wotherspoons to me are like the best summer shoe. I love my bright colors, so to me this thing is beautiful. Still up with courage, you're doing a service. Pull up to the crib, I'm equipped with the brush strokes. Cut throat from the low low when no love goes. Women buddy buddy like it's been dad. When a fuck me looking at the bill stack off the bubbly buddy. This beautiful side pouch. As you can see, we have the full Sean Wotherspoon colorway in a full corduroy material. The yellow is the main body with the green underneath. And what also comes inside is two pins. We have the Sean Wotherspoon shoe, and then the second pin I have put on the strap, and it is the Volkswagen minivan. You can see right there. It has the Problems kind of branding all throughout the strap. On the back we have a zipper, and it comes with the kind of like off-white yellow safety tag. The detailing once again with the Sean Wotherspoon shoe. I've kept this on because I think it's like an added accessory. The clipper inside, and just, when I talk about details in the whole packaging and this, the inside part is probably the biggest piece of detail out of all of it, and no one can really see it until you open your bag. They have embroidered a patch of Sean Wotherspoon himself. Like, I'm so shocked that he has not seen this brand. It says Wannabe Famous, Wannabe Problems, their full branding. Huge shout out to this brand, like, they've smashed it. They've also made a Sean Wotherspoon jacket. I think there's only 100 available, so the links will be in the description box below. So that was item number one. Moving on to the second item, this is a pair of shoes. So recently I thought, I finished university now, I wanna make some more money. I've kinda got into the sneaker reselling, so a lot of releases happen every single month. If you wanna see a video on how to resell, there'll be a link for one of my older videos in the description box below. I luckily managed to cop this pair of shoes. This was probably one of the best profit makers of June. And I never win raffles, like Nike sneakers, I just don't even bother anymore because I just never win. And you would have seen many reviews on this trainer. This is the Nike Dunk SB Low, this is the University Red. I won't go into full details because you can watch a review video, but look at the size of these. Like, I just thought, I never win raffles, so I'll just go for a UK 14. I know big sizes can sell for more. So this is the University Red. I've actually already sold these, so this is the final day with them. I managed to sell them for 270, so a nice 180 pound profit. So I'm fully happy with that. Sold it to StockX. The second pair of shoes that I managed to cop in June, it was the Jordan 5 Retro Top 3, I think that's the pronounce. It's a shoe right here, the photo. There actually wasn't that much good resale item. I bought them for 175, brand new. I got them in a UK 14 again, I went on end, and I think I sold them only for 190, so just a bit of lunch money, but it kind of adds up. And moving on to the third and final pair of shoes, these were sent to me, and I honestly couldn't believe when I got emailed by them. It is the brand Lacoste, so I'm pretty gassed that Lacoste messaged me. So this is an old school silhouette that they kind of remade from the 90s. It is a tennis shoe, nice chunky sole, definitely on trend at the moment. Very, very comfy and supporting on the heel when you're playing tennis. the green Lacoste crocodile on the side and a nice kind of prime upper, as you can see right there, and then it has the nice detailing on the other of the shoe. Huge shout out to Lacoste. A photo we styling these on my Instagram will be coming soon, so definitely be sure to follow me. Now I'll finish up with the shoes. We're gonna move on to the clothing. The first piece I am currently wearing, and as you can see, it is a Represent t-shirt, and I for ages have wanted this t-shirt. This is the Love Hunter. So we have the purple Represent text, the Cobra and the Naked Woman with the purple lightning bolts. I've wanted a black and purple vintage t-shirt for a while now. I just love the colorway, how it complements one another. I've really been sleeping on Represent with this. It's sold out, I think, like three times. I think this was the fourth release. And I know it's steep for a t-shirt, it's £90. But my boy JC, so be sure to follow his channel, he sold me out a discount, so I got it for £80. And honestly, Represent have just smashed. Like, they made like the perfect remade vintage tee. Like, it's got the washed out black. Like, my personal favorite t-shirt is my Marlboro one, and to compare this to my Marlboro one, it's pretty much exactly the same fit. We have the kind of drop shoulder, we have the nice high thick neck, but the nice kind of washing. I'd love when this starts to fade a little bit more, and then we have the nice kind of screen print. After a few washes, I think this will be even better when it starts to kind of crack. And with the Represent details, we have the little metal Represent buckle on the bottom of the t-shirt. Honestly, the fit is perfect. Mike and George Heaton honestly smashed it. They have a load of other sick graphic tees and graphic hoodies, so definitely check out Represent. So the next pickup is now from my new favorite vintage brand, and that is Vintage Burberry. Like, I just love the Novacek pattern, and I've been wanting this piece for so long. This is the Burberry Novacek Harrington jacket. So this one is a full Novacek pattern, goes pretty much everything. It's a bit of a strange logo. It's an embroidered logo, it's purple. I kind of wish that was kind of like black or even red. Like, purple's a bit random. Nice button detailing, the full zipper. You can wear it open or buttoned up. And what's even better with this jacket is this thing is reversible. So sick. You basically get two jackets for the price of one. So on the other side, more of a formal color. You have the nice navy. You can wear this for more like a smart casual look. But honestly, this piece is just staying in my collection forever. Goes with pretty much smart, the vintage look, and the casual look. That is my Burberry Harrington jacket. Next up, we have two tees, so perfect for the summertime. Once again, vintage t-shirt, saving the planet. We have this 80s white tag Adidas t-shirt. Like, the colorway on this, like I said, black and purple, the reds, the whites, the greens, and like the thickness of the t-shirt. Like, back in the day, the tees were just such better quality. It is actually not single stitch, it's double stitch, so maybe it's a 90s tee actually, not an 80s, but lovely embroidery on the Adidas, and it's just a standout t-shirt. Like, I just think you rarely come across t-shirts like this anymore, and I love bright colors. Next t-shirt, once again, this is a 90s Adidas. This is from the World Cup 94. I love the kind of gray colorway. It's got the nice high neck and thick quality, and then I just love the beautiful colors. Football is my favorite sport. If you didn't know, I used to play it quite a lot. I wanted to be a footballer. That was like my dream job until YouTube came along. So the next few pieces are accessories, and the first brand I want to talk about is called Gasper. They sent me out a little care package with a load of chains and rings. As you can probably tell right now, I'm wearing probably like 5 to 6 chains. I really love it, like the layering of them. I'll go for some more close-up details, but they sent me like 5 different chains and also 5 different rings. They are all at very, very affordable price points, and they are all very, very good quality. They don't give you green fingers. I mean, I've been in the shower with some of these, and the chains are just perfect, like essentials. Like, when you're first getting into jewelry, you don't want to like cash out on something like designer or something that's really expensive. You want to kind of start and base yourself somewhere, and the layering aspect just adds so much more character, I'd say, to any streetwear or like vintage outfit. It looks so sick with this Represent t-shirt, definitely. So the link to Gasper's website will be in the description box below, so definitely go check them out if you want some affordable jewelry. So moving on to the next accessories, this is actually from my company, Payday Vintage. So all these items I'm going to be showing right now are going to be on our website if you want to buy them. We have brought out 5 Nike rings and then 2 Thrasher chains. So we have the silver and gold signets. It's just a signet ring, and it has the Nike tick embossed inside with the nice black, pops really nicely. We have the swoosh ring, which is just on a square signet, a little bit different, a lot chunkier. And then my personal favorite, it is the all round swoosh. It's just a nice simple ring with the swoosh going all the way around. And we do this in a silver and a gold. Unfortunately, not a gold for the all round swoosh. And then coming to the chains, you may have seen it on my Instagram photo right here. This is the Thrasher chains. It's the Thrasher flame, nice and thick and heavyweight quality. And we also do it in a gold colorway too. All of the pieces too come at a very affordable price point. Not one of these pieces is over £25. So definitely check out our website and be sure to cop them. because I can't even lie, majority of these night rings sell out so fast. Moving on to the final pickup, this is another accessory. Once again, it is a vintage piece, and me personally, these are my favorite vintage bags, and that is the little Polo Sport pouches or purses. People say they're quite feminine, but I personally love them. They're really good in the summer when you're wearing shorts. Some shorts don't have pockets, so you can put in like your wallet, your sunglasses, your phone, your keys, pretty much everything. They have the Polo Sport kind of rubberized box logo, the Polo Sport kind of text underneath. Unfortunately, it's had some fading. The Polo Sport kind of tab at the side, metal, and just like add some extra bit of detail to any outfit. I've got this in a white colorway, and I thought I'd get the black colorway. Just the perfect essential for summer. So that was my June pickups. Let me know your favorite piece in the comment section down below. Me personally, it has to be that bag. Like, for detailing, that is just insane, but probably one of my favorite like monthly pickups, like the Represent tee, the Adidas tee, the Burberry reversible jacket, the shoes. Like, I became lucky on the shoes, I can't lie, winning the raffles. So it's going to be a very hectic week. I'm going to be filming every single day and editing every single day, so I probably won't be as active on my Instagram, but definitely be sure to follow it for recent fits and my pickups. It's at domhadley_. Let me know what kind of videos you want to see on this channel. I was thinking to go down the route of styling videos, how-tos, making money, photography, and then I'm planning eventually to start doing some documentaries and some podcasts. So let me know what you want to see, any video suggestions or ideas in the comment section down below. I'm so gassed to be back, and I hope you all enjoyed the video. So be sure to hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up, drop a comment, and I'll see you all in the next one.
Watch out for the people that ain't close to. Speak a little something you could toast to. I ain't trying to hear about what you won't do. Like I mean to hit the ground running like the rain do. Speak a little something that you're into. I ain't tryna hear about what you've been through. Like, hold up, say what.